Oh, what's up? I didn't see you there. Are you constantly tired of not knowing how to do the right exercise? Or having people constantly tell you that you're doing that exercise wrong? Well, I'm here to help you. My name is Corey and I'll be teaching you guys 5 exercises on how to properly form them and do them correctly. So let's get it.
Horizontal push-up. The first exercise that will be performed will be a push-up in the horizontal push stance. The muscles that are being activated in this exercise are the triceps, deltoids, and pectorals major. The first thing that you want to do is to get into the plank position with your elbows locked. Make sure that your back is straight and not bent. Have your hands be a shoulder width apart and have your legs be close to each other. Start by lowering your body down until your chest is about 2 to 3 inches from the ground, and then push yourself back up to your starting position. The common errors associated with this exercise is not having a straight back, having your elbows protruding out, and your hand position. The methods to correct these common errors are to flex your abs to keep your back straight and keeping it in neutral spine position. Concentrate on keeping your elbows close to the sides of your body. Also, place your hands shoulder width apart and have them pointing straight ahead. The next exercise that Corey is going to do is a pull-up in the vertical pull stance. The main muscles that are being used in this exercise are the trapezius, deltoids, lats, rhomboids, abs, and biceps. When performing this exercise, start by placing both hands in the box. Make sure that your hands are positioned wider than your shoulders. Once your hands are positioned, raise your body up. Bring both legs up and pull yourself high enough so that your chin goes past the bar. When going back down, make sure that you go down slowly and keep your legs bent so that you are engaging the abs. The common errors that usually occur in this exercise are not raising yourself high enough or not clearing the bar. The next common error is never extending and using your legs to raise yourself. To correct these methods, make sure you pull yourself up slowly and bend the legs to avoid kicking. Extended, slowly lower the dumbbells back to the starting position. Make sure that your back is straight and make sure that you are not leaning forward or backwards. Common errors that occur during this exercise are going too far down and limited range of motion. To correct these errors, don't allow your elbow joint to go past 90 degrees and use a weight that is not too heavy so that you can aim full range. This next exercise that is going to be performed is a box jump and squat stance. The muscles that are going to be used are the quads, glutes, and hamstrings. Stand with your feet shoulder width apart at a comfortable distance from the box. When you're ready to jump, drop quickly into a quarter squat, then extend your hips, swing your arms, and push your feet through the floor to propel yourself onto the box. Common errors that people tend to do while doing this workout is landing with your knees together, landing in a deep squat, and jumping down from the box. To prevent your knees from caving in, practice using a smaller box and practice perfect landing form. To prevent landing in a deep squat, use a box that allows you to jump and land in the same position, ideally a quarter or a half squat, and stick every landing. Land softly, but don't allow yourself to dip into a low squat. This teaches your hamstrings, glutes, and hip muscles to absorb the landing force instead of your joints, tendons, and ligaments. One of the most common mistakes that people tend to do after they perform the box jump, they jump down from the box. To fix this, after each rep, step down onto a slightly smaller box. If you're jumping to a 24-inch box, step down to a 12-inch box and then to the floor. The last exercise that will be performed is a forward lunge and a split stance. The main muscles that are going to be working are the glutes, quads, and hamstrings. The first thing that you want to do when performing this exercise is to stand up straight with your hands behind your head. Start by lifting your right leg and extend it forward while keeping your back straight and chest up. As you go forward, make sure that the knee does not go past your toes and make sure that your other knee touches the ground. Slowly push yourself up using the leg that is not touching the ground. The common errors that occur when performing this exercise is leaning too far forward and backward. Also, having the knee go past the foot. To correct these errors, focus on keeping your back straight and make adjustments to your lunging legs to prevent the knee from going past the toe.
Alright guys, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed my video. And always remember one thing, technique equals physique.